Today's a fine day for registering Pokemon. I love the smell of dexing in the morning. Well, isn't Rotom just excited? What is up, guys? My name is Flares, and welcome back to more Let's Play Pokemon Sun. And I will let you know that between the last episode, where we became Alola's first champion, and this episode, it's been about a month. Breaking the fourth wall real quick at the beginning of the video. I know, breaking the fourth wall. That last video was recorded at the end of November. It is now the end of December. You will probably see this in the middle or end of January. I'm not entirely sure. So that's how everything's kind of spaced out right now. So in the last episode, in case you missed it by chance, we became Alola's very first champion and captured ourselves a legendary Pokemon by the name of Tapu Koko. No, I did not forget. I was giving you a pause just in case you wanted to escape to the last episode so I didn't spoil it for you. If we check out our Pokedex, though, you can see we have 42% done, 126 captured, 244 seen in the Alola Pokedex. Yeah, we've seen a lot of Pokemon and captured a lot of Pokemon. And I'm half tempted to basically, like, complete the Alola Pokedex in the Let's Play, just for the sake of why the heck not. I have a copy of Moon that I can trade version exclusives between, and also show you guys where to find the certain version exclusives. You can see our Pokedex goes down to 291 right now. That is not the bottom of the Pokedex, I do know. I've done a lot of researching as stuff has come through in the past month, because I figure, to me, spoilers only matter in Pokemon until you've beaten the Pokemon League and become the champion. I'm sure you guys have noticed it sitting there in the back of the screen this whole time. There's a red shiny back there. Let's go pick up the Zygarde core. Suck it into our Zygarde cube. Xena wants to talk to you. Zzt. I said that you just collected another Zygarde core. Each of the core moves are memorized by the Zygarde cube, so you can teach Zygarde moves as many times as you like. Everything is up to you, Bon-sensei. That's all good and everything. You guys may remember that we didn't get the Zygarde cube until the second island. So I would like to start off post-game by basically re-exploring Melee Island and basically re-exploring all the islands just looking for Zygarde stuff. But more importantly, starting with Melee Island, because I haven't been to Melee Island since getting the Zygarde cube. So let's get a move on here. Looks like you slept well, Ryan. Yeah, for a whole damn month. Oh, hi, How. Alola! The salty breeze sang to me and brought me here to you! Yeah, see, Meowth is just as confused as I am. Oh, and there's that Cantonian Meowth. Look at that shiny coin on your head, kitty. I finally got my Gramps to go all out and be serious in a battle against me. I got some sweet rewards, so take this one, Ryan. Good luck is best shared. Decidium Z. And also a Primarium Z. These are the other starters. Z crystals. So, you know, so back in Melee Garden, I believe, we got the Incineroar Z for our Incineroar. Now we have the other two Z crystals for the other Pokemon. Hooray. Now you can power up too, Ryan. That's so nice of you, How. Thank you. Nah, no problem, Auntie. Say, is Kanto, like, really far away? It's pretty far. It's maybe. I don't know. It's pretty far. Well, it's true that it's not the next island or anything. But it's still close enough to visit whenever you want to. All right, then it's decided. I'm going to get stronger and stronger, and then I'm going to travel the world with my Pokemon. I'm going to go find Lily, and my dad, too. Your father? Yeah, he went out to get a pack of smokes and never came back. Sorry. Oh yeah, him. He's a strong trainer, real strong, I think. But I guess he really hated being the son of a Kahuna and everything, yeah. So he works far away from Alola these days. Really? Huh. I think I'm gonna go train myself up at the battle tree, then beat you, Ryan. And I'll be a champion next time I see him. Seems like a nice little present, eh? What is a battle tree, How? Oh, it's this thing way deep on Pony Island. Anybody who has passed the island challenge, or who is strong enough to anyway, can battle it out with their Pokemon. Or so they say. Ryan, let's have the best ever battle at that Pokemon League sometime. No backing out. At the Pokemon League, he says. He's actually talking about the champion defense titles. More on that in a moment. That's right. Now that you're the current champion, everyone is going to want to challenge you. Actually, never mind, the game's going to explain it for me. Or that's all they're going to say. So basically, what How and Mom are saying is that if we go and rematch the Pokemon League, which I believe they have rematch teams, they have more powerful teams now, I think. I don't remember off the top of my head. I know I've looked it up to make sure, and just now I'm second-guessing myself. So, yeah. If they do have rematch teams, I'll show them on screen. I'm pretty sure they do. And by show them on screen, I mean they'll be bonus videos. But once we get up to where we fought Kukui for the champion title, we have the chance of running into a number of other characters to defend our title as champion. It's kind of an interesting way to go about it, actually. I think it's really cool. Hey, you. You're the one they call Ryan. Not me. I can see right through any lies you tell, boy. A certain interested party sent me here to give you this. Enigmatic card. Okay. You should have a look at what it says. But take care where you read it. No one else is to know of my visit or that card. The hell? What the hell did you just give me, dude? Mysterious card written on it is a request for you to go to a guest room in an Akala motel on Route 8. What? Interesting. I seem to remember there being an empty guest room there. Or is that the one that Gladion was staying at? Okay, so that gives us something to do, I guess. Real quick, let's see, Melee Island just wraps around itself. Let's check the trainer school here. Just because I kind of want to run around and see if there's any differences anywhere. Mostly looking for Zygarde cores, or cores and cells, rather. Good luck with your island challenge. I completed it, girl. I am the champion. You know what I'm talking about? I don't see any green shinies. Watch me find, watch me notice one in the background, just, you know, in editing. Be like, you missed that one, you dumbass. Let's see here. Try to scoot around this grass as best I can. Doesn't look like there's anything here. I clipped the grass. Oops. What do we got? A Meowth. A lowland Meowth. Go on, Aki. I know you can do it. Yes, he's excited to fight this level 6 Meowth. All right. Let's see. By chance, is there anything? Maybe there's a Zygarde core in the school. I just want to be like really thorough here, just in case. I could always pull up a list of where they are. Like, that's a thing that I can do. In fact, I was poking around with that in PK Hex, just kind of looking, because apparently I could set it so that I have all the cores. But I'm not a dirty cheater. I was genning some stuff for a friend. So I backed up this save file and basically spammed through everything. I didn't read any of the text and didn't, like, look at anything. just so I could actually do stuff again. And luckily, didn't hit any story progress, after-game story progress anyway. There's a red book here. And how to trigger abilities. Huh. Don't need that. I'm gonna guess there's no cores in here. Doesn't look like it. Can I go upstairs? Like, I feel like I couldn't go up. Or, wait, no, is it? No, okay. Yeah, I couldn't get up here before. Hi there. You seem to have grown stronger. Think you could beat me, who has studied in this school for 30 years? I have the kahuna of this trainer school. Take my perfectly honed moves. Okay, so when's the soonest I could have fought him? You know what? I've been using Serebii for a lot of information, but it's been long enough that I think Bulbapedia might actually help or have a lot of information for me now. Let's see. Let's see here. Oh yeah, okay. Huh. This is actually a trainer that we're supposed to fight at this point. I just wanted to look. I should have just gone with it. He's got two Pokemon. He's got a Primeape. And show me the levels. 55. Aki is remembering the first time it met you. Let's see here. For you, I could go into Kurama or Bruxish. I kind of don't want to stick in an Aki because we're dark type. So I guess I'll go into Kurama. I am surprised that I'm actually, like, equally leveled on stuff here. You know, there's not really a lot of black belts in this game, is there? Hmm. Damn, that did a lot of damage. Am I faster? I'm faster. Okay, it's all good. I'm faster. So if I would have come up here earlier, would he have told me to come back when I've completed my island challenge or something? I have a feeling that's what would have happened. He's got a Lucario. This one I feel okay going into Aki because it's part steel. I could just flare blitz it. Or flamethrower, but I'm a physical attacker. Ooh, close combat. It's faster than me. Right, because Incineroar is actually really slow. Wait a minute. Shite. Oh, crap. What do I do here? Oh, I go into Sue and I high jump kick. See, the problem is it's been so long since I've played this game. I've been playing other Pokemon games in the meantime. Because off screen, I've been playing through basically every generation of Pokemon with SS2 Jet and what the hell does Misha even go by anymore? The Mediocre, I think, is her YouTube still. I know she's Cinesquiggle on Twitter. Yeah. I beat him. Yay. Oh, I can enter now? My perfectly honed moves. I guess this is why I still can't graduate even after 30 years. And I graduated the same day I started. So what's in here? Welcome to the trainer school. I am the principal. What an honor for me and the school. I think that our teachings would not only give rise to a captain, but to a league champion. Despite your lofty accomplishments, though, I'd hazard that you still don't know everything that the trainer school has to teach you, eh? Then allow me to give you a special expert lesson from the principal herself. I should have healed. Oh, crap. She's got three Pokemon. Principal Asuka. Asuka? Asuka? Oh. Granbull, hey? I have Flash Cannon for that. Because Granbull is... Oh, Granbull's got Intimidate. I'm a special attacker, it ain't no problem. Flash Cannon, this mofo. Ooh, I almost one-shot it. I'll go for another Flash Cannon. Down goes the Granbull. Arcanine. You have an Arcanine. Okay, we'll go into Bruxish. I'm still really surprised how good Bruxish is as a Pokemon. Like, it's not a bad Pokemon. And here's Intimidate. Is your entire team just going to be Intimidators? Because that's kind of a pain in the butt. And actually, that hurts Bruxish because Bruxish is a physical attacker. Oh god, your Arcanine has Outrage. I might have to send my Fairy type in. Good thing I'm faster. Oh. Maybe I should have just used Aqua Jet. I'm getting beat up in this episode, damn! What do I do? I'll go into Athena. Check out my Kamo-o. Sky Uppercut. Because I'm a physical attacker, even though Clanging Scales is like my signature move or whatever. Really? And I'm a dragon. I'm a dragon. That's... Okay. Dragon Claw? Oh god, it's faster than me. We must be speed. Oh no, it extreme speeded. It's an Arcanine. Of course it's gonna have extreme speed. Wow, I am a bad Pokemon trainer. I am a really bad Pokemon trainer. Like, look at this. I'm sending a bug out against a fire type. I am awful. What is wrong with me? It punched itself in the face. All right. I'll take it. Stoutland. Alright, I can go into Sue for that, because Sue has high jump kick. Have I really not fought a Stoutland before? I know I have a Lillipup in the PC. I think I fought a Herdier before, but apparently I haven't fought a Stoutland, because it's not showing me the effectiveness of my moves. Stupid Intimidate. Oh, now it is. Now it's showing me the effectiveness. Okay. High jump kick has a cool animation. Oh god, you have Fire Fang. You thought of everything. Why would you... Lucario, I guess? Is what you would expect from that? This is the stab. Oh, come on. Ice Fang. You just have elemental fangs on there? I mean, I guess that'd be good for Kamo-o. Just drop kick. Drop this puppy. Also, Stoutland was her only Pokemon to be male. Not that that has anything to do with anything, but, you know. Wow, you're something else! Apparently I am. Just as the saying goes, even the fool may give the wise man good counsel if he listens. I may have lost, but heed my advice and use this. It is one of my favorite items. King's Rock. If your Pokemon is holding the King's Rock, its attacks may make an opponent flinch. And that's the end of what I can teach you. I'm glad I was able to meet you here. Is that the first possible instance of getting a King's Rock? Because that kind of... I know you can catch Slowpoke in this game. And you need a King's Rock to evolve it into a Slow King. Because if you can't get a Slow King until post-game, that kind of sucks. So I didn't find any Zygarde cores around here, but I found optional battles and items that I couldn't get earlier. Neat. It actually is kind of neat. I'm going to go to the Pokemon Center now, because damn, I got my ass kicked. I'm actually legitimately surprised I got my ass kicked in that far. Makes me not want to go to the Battle Tree yet. Especially because I have some idea of what's at the battle tree. Do I have any different items here now that I've won? You're the first ever champion in Alola! Congratulations! Thank you for coming here! It looks like your island challenge will continue even after becoming the champion. Blah, 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 blah. Do I have any new items? I don't actually remember what was here. Did they add full restores? I don't think they actually added anything. Maybe? I don't know. Not 100% sure here. Okay. I just had to remember what my button was. Let's move here. So there's actually an area here in Haoli City that I totally skipped over after we defeated Hala. I'm going to explore the beach a little bit. I can surf here, though. Which one am I going to jump on? Lapras? Yeah. Okay. Out of curiosity, there's going to be... Oh, hello, Melee Melee Sea. There's a fishing spot here. What does the Melee Melee Sea have for me? Besides Magikarp, of course, because that's all I ever find while fishing. Anger! Anger and hate are supreme. I can apparently find Finneon just by surfing. In fishing, I have a chance of finding Corsola and Lovedisc. Corsola is an interesting Pokemon to actually run into because... Via the SOS system, it gives... There's, like, nothing over here. There's gotta be a hidden item here. I have to remember what my shortcuts are. But finding a Corsola, you're able to find a Marini, which is a new Pokemon of this generation. It's also the only way to find said Pokemon. Found a rare candy over there. Is that all that's over here? I won't be completely disappointed if it is. I'll just be surprised. Oh god, there's a trainer there. And she spotted me. Wearing that getup seems too hot. Have a good sweat in a battle. I mean, if you say so. I'm going to imagine you're going to be rather low leveled because I'm probably able to fight you a lot sooner than now. You have a Goldeen. Yeah, no, you're going to be like level 20 something, aren't you? Because they need to make it possible for me to beat you. Yeah, level 13. Aki is interested in the other Pokemon's scent. They're in a cold sweat from losing. Should have put her behind a rock, so at least I would need Sharpedo Jet for this. Oh, there's a cave there. What's in the cave? Oh, we're in 10 Carat Hill now. There's a TM back here. TM64 Explosion. Why is Explosion a TM? I mean, it's cool and all, but why? These are the same encounters as the other part of 10 Carat Hill. Rock and rolla. Probably true. Yeah. The levels tell me everything. Can't get back here without Sharpedo Jet, but Pokemon are the same level. Okay. Can I actually wrap around all the way to Route 1 here? It looks like I can. This is still Melee Melee Sea. There's a trainer out here. But look, I'm on Route 1. Okay, that's neat to know. God damn it, Wingull! There's some Corsola up on the beach here. Oh, I see a green shiny. Pokemon seem to be hurt. What will you do? Take it to a Pokemon Center? Sorry, I know, I took way too long. Huh? I just left my Pokemon here to play for a little bit while I was shopping in town. I checked that there weren't any Pokemon here that would bully my Corsola, but there was a Marini hiding in the rocks. Oh, I want to fish it up and show it up my wrath. Marini love breaking off and eating Corsola's branches more than anything else in the world. They hunt Corsola down mercilessly to gnaw and nibble on their branches. Sure, the Corsola's branches can regenerate, and they'll eventually grow back, but that doesn't make it any less scary for Corsola. You were worried about my Corsola and trying to help them, weren't you? Thank you, you're a really nice trainer. Here, take this from me. It might come in handy. A wide lens. Come on, let's get you both all better. Off to the Pokemon Center. Okay, here's a green shiny back here. Grab you from Kukui's lab. I will make the assumption that's the only one in the vicinity because it's kind of a wide open area. What's Kukui got for us now that we are late champion? Anything hiding in his house? Hey there, Ryan. Looks like you're really giving it your all. Yeah! You've got a lot of Pokemon registered in your Pokedex now. Of course he has. Ryan is my big boy. I wouldn't bother hanging out with some lug of a trainer who couldn't fill a Pokedex. Rotom's pretty fired up about it, too. Of course I am, too. So I've got a little something for you. Got a lucky egg. When you have a Pokemon hold a lucky egg, it grows up faster. Some evolved Pokemon don't appear in the wild, so it's useful to have one of these if you're trying to fill a Pokedex. Damn straight it is. What's up in Lily's loft? It's kind of cleaned out, actually. They look pretty advanced. There's a diary that looks to belong to Lily. Murkrow seems to have pecked apart the glittering lock on the front. Will you open the diary and read it? Sure. She's not here. I finally decided I have to leave Paradise so that I can protect Nebby. I told Wick about it, my plans in secret, and she told me I should find someone named Professor Burnett and speak to her, that she might be able to help. Wick thinks that this Professor Burnett woman is researching the Ultra Wormholes. I wonder what kind of person she might be, and how will I ever find her? I don't even know where in Alola she might be right now. Nebby shone brighter than anything, and before I knew what had happened, we had found a way to meet Professor Burnett. But how did we get there? Is it some strange power that Nebby has? Did it do this? Professor Burnett called her husband at once, a man named Professor Kukui. He came to meet us, and he walks about half naked all the time. I don't know about that. Is it some kind of Alolan fashion or something? In the end, it was decided that Professor Kukui would let me stay in his research lab with him. He took me there in his boat. It didn't look like it could even survive the voyage, but we arrived in one piece, and the sea breeze was delightful. When we arrived at the marina, the kahuna of the island was there with his grandson. That is how I came to meet Kahuna Hala and Hau. I've since come to learn the Alola region has no gym leaders or champions or any of that. Today was certainly an eventful day. Nebby kept acting like it wanted to go see the ruins of conflict, but when we tried to visit them, it was suddenly attacked by Spearow. It was just terrible. All I could do was stand by and watch. But then a stranger appeared and helped us. At first, I thought it was someone from Aether that they had tracked us down at last. But it was actually a boy that the professor knows. Ryan, I won't forget him. I read the entire thing. Huh. Have the prologue in text form. What are you doing, Stuffle? Fuff. Anything change in the... He walked back over here. Uh-huh. Wait, what? Oh yeah, I got something solid for you, cousin. TM70 Substitute. Bitchin'. Substitute is a sweet move that uses 1/4 of the Pokemon's HP to make a copy of it. Oh yeah. The best thing about it is that it keeps your Pokemon safe from most status moves, yeah. And you can make a real wicked combo if you use it with items that are triggered when you lose HP or gain HP back, you follow? If you're champion, you should work on having some real fine technique in battle, little cousin. Agreed. Anything down here that could be of use? Oh, okay, so we've got this, it's full of cardboard boxes containing electrical appliances. This is, I don't know if I made note of that earlier, but that'd be where if we had a Rotom, we would be able to switch its forms. Somebody who hacks Mondance into their game found that out. You have any, nope. Okay. I guess we clean this out. Looking at my map, though, there seems to be something way off in the distance here. So let's jet over there. There's an island over here with an item on it. I found soft sand. Excellent. Huh. Okay. Let's see. Let's hop on Charizard and fly back over to Howley City. All the way over here. The other side of Howley City, I guess. Adequate enough. Because there is one thing I do know about in Howley City that we missed after we defeated Hala. Over here, look, the doors are open. These doors weren't open before we defeated Hala, but they've been open since we defeated Hala. This is the Howley City Mall. Our wide variety of goods and services will astound you. Please enjoy your fill of our full-service mall. So, interestingly enough, there's quite a number of things that we can get here. There's a clothing store. Okay, that's actually really cool and something I didn't expect. Let's change our getup, right? We can do that. Oh my goodness, we are luckily fat stacked enough that... So weird, why is it only the button row that changes color? That's kind of silly. Pinstripe collared shirt. Oh, okay, yeah, pinstripes, yes. No pants, no socks. You got shoes. I could wear some loafers. That backpack looks neat. Those backpacks are expensive, though. Whoa. Get me some aviators. Pink aviators to match the rest of my outfit. Okay, expensive clothing store. I must go grind money. Do you just have the same stuff? Oh, please accept this gift in our appreciation for your patronage. You obtained the Grace Idea! So if I had a Shaman, I could turn it into Sky Form. This is a Grace Idea flower, which our brand name was inspired by. I give it to you to express the appreciation we feel towards our customers for choosing us. I heard that Grace Idea flowers have an effect on a certain Pokemon as well. We hope to look forward to your continual patronage in the future. And like I just explained, that works with Shaman to allow you to turn it into its sky form. During the daytime, I think, specifically. Let's see here. What else we got? This shop is curated for the true collectors. Average traders have no need of our goods. I would consider your purchases carefully so that you do not waste your money in vain. What do you have? Ah, welcome to Antiques of the Ages. This is a very select antique shop. This shop is interesting. We have new stock in today. If you would care to have a look, the owner can tell you more. He is the gentleman standing beside me. There is only one of each of the treasures that you can find in our shop. The Adamant Orb, the Lustrous Orb, the Grisius Orb, the Red Orb, the Blue Orb, or just nothing. So, for the unacquainted of you, the Adamant Orb will power up Dragon and Steel type moves of the Pokemon Dialga. The Lustrous Orb will power up Dragon and Water-type moves of the Pokemon Palkia. The Grisius Orb will allow the Pokemon Giratina to turn into its origin form. The Red Orb allows the Pokemon Groudon to Primal Revert into its Primal Groudon form. Yeah. The Blue Orb will allow the Pokemon Kyogre to Primal Revert into Primal Kyogre. I think I said Kyogre. Supposed to be Kyogre. All of these, I believe, are ridiculously expensive. That's not horrible. We can go ahead and probably buy all of these then. Adamant Orb. Oh, I didn't read that. I heard that it has something to do with a Pokemon that rules over time. We thank you for your pretty blah 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 blah. Oops. I'm sorry, young sir, but it seems we are out of stock of that item. Yeah, I thought it would take it off the list. That's why I was mashing through the text. The Lustrous Orb? It's 10,000 Pokedollars. Would you like to purchase it? Yes, please. You obtained a Lustrous Orb. We purchased that particular item from the Sinnoh region. I've heard that it has something to do with the Pokemon that controls space. The Grisius Orb. 10,000 Pokédollars. Yes, I would like to purchase. We purchased that particular item from the Sinnoh region. I've heard that it has something to do with a Pokémon that lives in the Distortion World. What else do you have? Red Orb. It's 10,000 Pokédollars. Yes, please. You obtained a Red Orb. We purchased that particular item from the Hoenn region. I've heard that it has something to do with a Pokémon that rules the land. And Blue Orb. We purchased that particular item from the Hoenn region. I've heard that it has something to do with a Pokémon that rules the sea. Oops, I didn't mean to... D-pad, man. D-pad doesn't move. Some new arrivals, though I'm not... Oh, the Sky Plate, the Zap Plate, the Stone Plate, the Iron Plate, the Fist Plate, the Dread Plate, the Splash Plate, the Pixie Plate. That's interesting. That's not all of the plates, though. I read somewhere that you can get most of the plates from this guy. I think this might be all of them that he has. How much do they cost? 10 each? Okay, I'll take them. Wipe me flat. Let's see, what's he gonna say here? Yes, I picked that one up in the Sinnoh region. They say it was somehow related to a Pokemon that had something to do with the universe. Then the delivery truck was attacked by those skull people on the way to the store. I showed them who was boss, but, well, it was a real ruckus, so they still got away with my stock. To have that happen right here in Haoli, I don't have time to waste on tracking it down again, but if you find it, feel free to take it. Well, that's good to note. Oh, wait, this one actually, like, takes them off the list. So I should just spam through the text. I picked that one up in the Sinnoh region. They say it's somehow related to a Pokemon that has something to do with the universe. Okay, he's not going to tell me the whole story. Good. Wait, did I get the Sky one? Because I just bought the Zap one. And the Stone one. Never mind. Number 3. It's going to say all the same text. Wish you would just tell me, like, the lore on the plate. Because then it would actually be different text. I think the only time they've ever had, like, the actual lores that are on the plate is in Gen 4. In the Sinnoh games. Oops. Did I get the iron one? Yes, I did. Okay. This plate. I'm gonna be out of cash. And then the Dread Plate. The dreaded Dread Plate. For those that... Oops, I clicked the wrong one again. For those that aren't acquainted with... Acquainted with the plate items... they work in a way that they're specialized for the Pokemon Arceus, the god of all Pokemon. I'm mashing through text again. Oops. God damn it. This is the last one. Okay. The plate items are specialized for the Pokemon Arceus. It'll change its type into whatever type is specialized by the plate, but they can be held by regular Pokemon as well. And power up the moves that are, you know, associated with that plate. So, if we go to our regular items here, you can see the Pixie Plate boosts the power of Fairy-type moves, Splash is Water, Dread is Dark, Fist is Fighting, Iron is Steel, Stone is Rock, Zap is Electric, Sky is Flying, yada 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 yada. Here's the other items that we picked up as well. We picked up a lot of items just there. A lot of items that we actually have minimal use for. Do you have any Pokemon from an island kahuna? It doesn't matter if it's evolved into something else since then. As long as it's a fire, water, or grass type Pokemon from a kahuna, it's really friendly towards you, I'll teach it a special move, a battle combo move. Yes? Which Pokemon will it be then? What can I teach Incineroar? a battle combo move, she says. What? Oh, the pledge moves. Yes, okay, so a column of fire hits the target. When used with its grass equivalent, its power increases and a vast sea of fire appears. 80 power? Whoa, that's actually really good if you were a special attacker. Aki did not learn Fire Pledge. You can't call this ride Pokemon. The name's Mr. Hyper. Do you know why I'm so hyper? Because I can help Pokemon do hyper training. Allow me to explain. Hyper training is a way to help Pokemon that have reached level 100 become even stronger. The special training can help them increase their strength and HP and other stats. If you want me to train up your Pokemon, bring me some bottle caps. I collect them. A regular bottle cap will get you training for a single stat. But bring me a rare gold bottle cap, and I'll train all of your Pokemon stats to the max at once. Whoa! I don't have any bottle caps, though. I'm devoting what's left of my life to helping young trainers grow. I'd like to teach the ultimate moves to as many successors as I can. You teach Blast Burn and Frenzy Plant and Hydro Cannon? I'm gonna guess that's a yes. Yeah, we'll be replaced with Blast Burn. I don't want to teach Blast Burn for two reasons. One, I don't really care for the elemental hyper beams. On top of that, it's a special type, or it's a special base move, and I'm a physical attacker. There's a lot of stuff in here. Wow, I didn't realize how big this place was. I think that's really all I wanted to show off, though, in particular. I don't think there's anything else too special. If there is, I'll come back. But with that, we are getting up there on that amount of time that we spend on videos. So I suppose we'll end off here next to the Pokemon Center. We haven't done too much battling since last healing, so I don't think I need to heal up. But with that, guys, that's going to be it for today's episode of Let's Play Pokemon Sun. In the next episode, we'll continue re-exploring the region and hitting up stuff that we've missed. Until the next one, though, my name is Flares. Thank you guys for checking out the video. Make sure you leave a like down below if you enjoyed it. Dislike if you thought it sucked. Leave a comment down below if you feel so obligated to do so or just want to say hi. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys right back here for the next episode of Let's Play Pokemon Sun.